He is one among the few Ayurvedic physicians from Kerala practicing the Ashtangas of Ayurveda, following the school of thought of Kaikulangara Ramavaira of Kashyapa tradition. Traditionally, he is specialized in Bala Chikitsa and Visha Chikitsa. He is expert in Ayurveda dermatology, especially Bala Visarpa. He took his BAM with rank in 1981 from Ayurveda College, Kottakkal, took MD Ayurveda in Kaya Chikitsa with special subject Visha from Postgraduation Institute, Trivandrum in 1984. He was appointed as a faculty VPSV Ayurveda College, Kottakkal in 1985, worked as professor and HOD in Agadanta Department, VPSV Ayurveda College, Kottakkal up to 2012 April. Sir has presented several scientific papers in various national and international seminars, published several scientific articles in various journals, published the book Avabhasini, a handbook on Ayurveda dermatology, published the English translation of Vishavaidya Jyotsika, the Kerala traditional Vishavaidya Grantham. Sir has conducted several scientific lectures in various conferences. He has been the faculty for several ROTP organized under Ayush Department, organized several training classes for Ayurvedic doctors. He has rendered the service as faculty for Panchakarma Training and Orientation course organized by Arya Vaidya Shala Kottakkal and National Institute of Panchakarma Cherturthi. He has been awarded the PS Warrior Award by Arya Vaidya Shala Kottakkal in 1983, awarded the Vagbhata Puraskaram by the Vagbhata Sarini, the Ayurveda wing of Swadeshi Science Movement in 1997. He was one among four Gaveshak Ratnam Award finalists in 2007 for the best PG thesis competition organized by KAPL. He was awarded the Gandhi Sevana Puraskaram by Mahatma Gandhi Center for Education and Research in 2008. For concentrating fully in own traditional center, he took voluntary retirement from his services in April 2012 and developed a traditional center as modern international level. Presently, he is director of Dhanvantri Institute of Dermatology, where training classes are being organized for young Ayurvedic physicians. Now I invite Dr. P.K. Moharana, HOD Department of Roga Vijnana and Vikruti Vijnana, to honor our guest. Now I request Sri M. Sri Krishnan sir to share his clinical experiences.
Om Shri Guru Bhyo Namah. Chatubhujam Pidavastram Sarvalankara Shobhidam Dhyaye Dhanyundarim Devam Surasire Namaskritam. My humble salutation to my gurus, my parents, and to the August Assembly. The students sitting backside, please come forward. It is better to occupy in the front seat. Come forward. Don't let vacant the front seats. You come forward. Welcome to my institution, my Institute of Dermatology. Today is my subject, management of skin disease and Ayurvedic approach. I think yesterday to the college students we had some workshop and some discussion. In that we have discussed some etiological factors and some morphological factors. Today I am fully concentrating on the management area or the treatment area. See, clinical importance of skin disease, as per my experience and as per a random clinical survey, 50% of the OP patients in general practice suffering from skin disease of an average Ayurveda practitioner. Among that, 10% is only incurable, and 50% is curable, 40% is successfully manageable. So the scope of Ayurveda practitioner in the management of dermatology is 90%. How? See, in the text where the dermatological description we can meet in Kushtaroga, Visarpa, Vadashonda, Kshudraroga, Sairoroga and Agadandra. You can see the references of the dermatological problem in all these references in our classical text. And common dermatological problem approaching to an Ayurvedic doctor, we can say Visarpam, Vicharthika, Kidibam, Vibhadiya, Sitma, Megha, Kushtam, Vyengya, Mugadoshika, Vidradi, Kodam, or in modern words, bacterial viral infection, fungal parasitic infection, psoriasis, lichenomyelitis, ichthyosis, eczema. Among that, seborrheic eczema and atopic eczema is more, and some cosmetic problem. Nowadays, the fungal and psoriasis and eczema is more. Also, the cosmetic problems is increasing to the overusage of cosmetic. Here, think our actually the tuk or skin is not properly identified by the modern physiology or anatomy. We have studied something that we came to know that a bag is a bag for the body, and it's the most tortured organ in our body. But at the same time, it is the most obedient organ. You have studied it is the largest organ in the body, but it is the most obedient and it's most tortured because it suffers the beating and painting and scratching. Whatever we are doing, we can do, we will do the skin. But even though it is obedient to some extent, it will obey. After that, it will exacerbate. That is the skin disease. And for a proper management, Charaka says, Rogatnyanartham evado yatnagare beshak bhavid. Understand the disease first. Rogatnyanam is very important. How Rogatnyanam? Rogam nidana pragruva lakshana uvashayaptimi. Understand the roga nidana, purvaruba, lakshana, samprapti and upashaya. Or we can clinically, it is etiological diagnosis, morphological diagnosis and clinical diagnosis. And in this way, if you are understanding the disease, the management is very simple. Nidana is very clearly stated in our science, especially Charaka. In that, Shidoshna Lengana Aharam Kramam Bukta Nishayavidam, all these factors is Navanadari, Malsyadi, Ramla Niveshya, all these Nidana etiological factors are still relevant from my clinical experience. Shidoshna Lengana Aharam, you see, nowadays in the Gulf area, the psoriasis and other diseases are increasing. The one important, in the Gulf, the people working in the AC, not only in the Gulf here, the people working in the AC, occasionally they are going outside. So at the same time, the body is subjected to different climate. That will alter due to the acclimatization process, the body is altering its physiology. And gradually, the chemical release leads to pathological change. All the etiological factors, and Vagbada is conceived. Midyahara viharena visheshana virodina. Include everything. Midyahara viharena visheshana virodina. Sadhu nindavadanya soharanata bhapme karme sadhyo. Praktane viridamala. Simple psychological problem, psychological cause and intentional cause. That is midyahara vihara. Then sira prabhadya didyakta tuklesi gasra amishan dosha endesli digirdya. Nishtiranda tadobhi. This is samprapti. Nidana and samprapti. So, think what is happening nowadays, what we are subjected to expose our body. These are the etiological factors of dermatology. We can think what is happening to the body. Now, just to visualize the Nidana and Samprapti, what our Acharyas tell. The etiological causes, different types of etiological causes, induce the dosha gaba, that is vada, pitta, gaba. Actually, vada is the controlling factors, and pitta is the metabolic factors. Gaba may be the protoplasmic and fluid medium. It causes the dhadu dushti, that is tuklesiga asriga amisham, that is the skin and lymph, blood, body fluids and muscular tissue. And what is the ectiopathogenesis? Due to the different etiological factors, there will be a formation of amavisha in the endotoxins in the cellular area. And that causes the srodo dushti, that is obstruction of the metabolic channel. It leads to the kosha nasham or cell death. And lastly, a shobolpa, the fluid accumulation in the dermis is happening. Or we can call it a malasanjiyam, or accumulation of endotoxin and medomamsa dushti, kabasanjiyam and shobolpati. These are as per the samprapti shloka. Explore the samprapti shloka into visualize. So this is the etiological etiopectogenesis and emergence of disease. Again, what is meant by srodas? Srodamsikalu parinamamabhyamananam abhivahini bhavanti ayanarthena. It includes the internal transport system or the all metabolic pathway and receptor channels, even in the ion channel, and even the neurotransmission pathway include the srodas. And the srodo dushti is three types: rodham, sangojam and shobham, maybe obstruction, spasm and inflammation. So what is malasanjaya? Actually, it is formation of amamisha or accumulation of endotoxin. In biopsy, you think about the toxicosis condition or retention toxicosis condition. The toxic material accumulated in our body or cell is supposed to excrete from the body or by maybe due to the incapacity of the excretory organ to excrete the accumulated toxins, or the accumulation, huge amount of toxin when accumulated in the body is not able to excrete. That toxin will accumulate in the cellular level here and there. That cause the toxicosis condition. That refers to the amasanjeev or malasanjeev. So let us see what is happening in the skin or in the cellular level. You think this is the homeostasis mechanism in tissue, samavastha in the skin happening. Here the arterial end is passing the venous end. The fluid, the nutrition and blood is coming to interstitial fluid and the excretion to the venous end. Excess fluid will be maintained by the lymphatic system and each and every cell is maintained by a proper pure interstitial fluid. Unless the interstitial fluid is not properly maintained, the cellular function will not be proper. Thus, our body have a one single cellular cover, germinative layer. That germinative layer should be work properly by multiplication. So when the interstitial fluid should properly maintain by its purity or its nutrition, that is happening when the arterial blood flow should be in the proper way or maintaining the arterial blood flow. That depends upon the recta vaha srodas, recta, content of the recta, specific gravity of the recta, any minor change that refers to recta dushti. Cause defect in the interstitial fluid. And here the resa recta vaha, medomamsa, everything is considered here. So what is happening in the pathological level? When the recta dushti is there, here the artery will be dilated, rodo dushti is there, rodham, sankojam or spasm. That cause the dilatation of venous and lymphatic system, the interstitial fluid will be defected, the kosha nasham will happen. Or when it, the cause is action, internally due to mithyahara vihara. As a morning, as allergy is describing the histamine, what will happen? When histamine released, automatically vasodilatation will happen. So gradually articaria, everything will happen. So external cause and internal cause, when the recta dushti is there, interstitial fluid will be defective, the kosha nasha will be, refers to in the dermis, the disease will come. Actually in the subtle level, this is happening. Still, in the subtle level, the cell will adjust. Homeostasis mechanism will be maintained within the cell and due to the external influence. But due to the chronic accumulation, what is happening? Cellular toxin, when to frequent exposure, there will be defect in the cellular metabolism. When the cellular metabolism is altered, the cumulative toxicity in the cellular area, it is not able to adjust with the external fluctuation and internal fluctuation. And gradually it will affect the mitochondria of the cell, which is the transmitter or which is the energy transmitter site of the cell. When the energy in the cell is lowered, the cell is not able to viable. So the kosha nasham is happening. And here, even when the mitochondria energy vibration will be altered, it is altered the homeostasis mechanism in the cell and the cell death is happening. Actually, this is the basic pathology happen to almost all the disease. When this reaction or this pathological change happening in the liver, liver cirrhosis will come. When it is happening in the brain, brain damage will happen. When it is happening in the kidney, kidney stuck will be happened. And when it is a lung, and when it is a uterus, and when it is the ovary, it is the cause for the PCOD, it is the pathology of the PCOD. The same pathology is happening in the uterus, in the ovary, the PCOD will come. And when it is in the skin, different skin disease come. So this is the pathological change happening in the subtle level. And now, think one example. This is a case of ichthyosis case. My name is Eka Gushtam, Eka Akhya Mahasaram Aswedha Malisa Shakal Saminibam. This is actually the patient from Kasaragod, this toxic induced, and the very endosulfan induced area, patient is from Kasaragod. Actually, in the modern way, it is called hyperkeratosis. The hyperkeratosis due to toxin, here the pathology is release of antigen and the cell mediated immune response will be there, and inflammation of the lymphocytes, cytokines, IgEs, etc. perform a degenerative keratinocyte, and that is a colloid formation. And due to that, the increased steroid sulfate will be released. that cause the decreased membrane coating granules here, and hence the cell to cell adhesion is more. So desquamation mechanism is defective and retention ability formed cell, that is called the ichthyosis here. In our sign, it is a agakushtitis vada kabaja. What is happening in the vada kabaja stage? The vada kaba is there in the vada pitta kaba. Here, due to the rasadadu dushti, the jalam dadu is decreasing and vayu and prithvi dhuda is increasing. So due to the vayu and prithvi dhuda, the vayu ruchala of vayu is causing shoshana of the prithvi dhuda, cause the shoshana in ichthyosis or keratoderma like disease. This is the pathology or samprapti happening in our body in this type of disease. And one more, see, this is the histopathology of psoriatic patient. Here, in the psoriasis, the superficial layer, stratum corneum, stratum albigeum is loose. At the same time, in the dermis, you can see the lymphocytic administration and the capillary dilatation. Here, the fluid accumulation is there. By the superficial morphology, it is a dry lesion. But in the dermis, there will be accumulation of the fluid. And this is the chronic and acute eczema. In the acute histopathology slide of acute eczema, here, the lesion is very oozing and very soggy. Here it is dry, and here the epidermis, in the epidermis is almost fluid. In the dermis also fluid accumulation and lymphocyte accumulation we can see. Even though the chronic stage the skin is dry superficially, in the deeper side, even though the superficial epidermis is dry, stratum granulosum is dry, in the dermis, lymphocytes and vascular dilatation we can see. That means in the dermis, in the deeper side, ulceration will be there. That is called tolglesiga, asrgamishan, dushayanda, shradigirtya, dushta, kushtamushandida. So in the management, due to this, even though the morphology in the superficial it is dry, deeper side, it will be accumulation of the fluid. That is our Ajarya says, iti doshe vijide ande, toksheshamanam behi plebadihidam. Without clearing the deeper side of dosha, when you are applying any external application, it will be increased due to the excess of ulceration. So this is very important in the management. And for the reference, you just think about the Shobhanidana and the Samhitas also, contact dermatitis you can see from the Sushruta, and the concept of allergy formation of dermatology problem in Samhita you can refer. And see, an example, this is the cumulative toxicity of the meat. By the etiological factor, daily morning and evening he is taking chicken daily. And this is a 10 years chronic problem he are suffering, and actually this is from some seborrheic that is a pustular psoriatic lesion. Actually all the signs and symptoms of psoriasis we cannot say. Actually we diagnose it is a vijarthiga, because the all the signs and symptoms like sagandu petagashiava lesigade vijarthiga, and the cause is over accumulation of the toxin in her in his body. This is the papillo squamous disorder, that is sitma gushta, clearly due to endotoxins. And this is a parthenium dermatitis, chronic allergic eczema. Actually, the patient is from Coimbatore. And this is allergic eczema due to kungumum, usually cosmetic, or not only cosmetic, all the even the sandalwood also artificially prepared is causing this type of problem. And here, allergy due to some flower. And this is a polyester allergy, cloth allergy. Nowadays, polyester dress is causing allergy severely. And this is dermatography allergic disease. And this is nowadays scleroderma, the autoimmune disease, and although the collagen disorders are increasing due to the improper food habits and the lifestyle. And several patients are approaching in the because in the modern there is no treatment for this, only antihistamine and steroid. So they are approaching for alternative therapy to Ayurveda people. Here, contact dermatitis due to chappal, different chappals. And you know, chappal is not causing any problem, but the chemical added in the tanning process of the leather is causing this process. So when you are using adipoli cherup, cause tolipoli disease. For the Malayali people, adipoli will cause tolipoli. So don't use any other adipoli chappal. And this is another chronic vijardhya or padugavisha usage of chappal. And this is our spectacle allergy. Spectacle allergy, you can see here, same spectacle allergy contact. This is ornamental allergy, colis allergy. This is detergent allergy, housewife's problem. Now this is solar dermatitis due to the sunlight. And this is he actually the patient is came from an Ayurvedic hospital after a peachil. When the heated oil caused the peachil, this problem happened. Heated oil allergy. The patient came from an Ayurvedic hospital after the peachil of 7 days. Maybe due to the oil or maybe due to the heat. And this is conduct of the dusparsha, that is plant allergy. And this, I told you, this actually the patient was suffering from some sort of vesicular bullous disorder. One Vaidyan or one Ayurvedic doctor given gulguldikta grida, and this allergy came. And now this is allergy to the chemical allergy due to watch strap of a watch. Now this is a heat allergy, acne vulgaris, due to the heat and some powder. This is mugadushya or solar effect. Actually the patient was suffering after the chicken pox. She applied some ointment for removing the black spot of the chicken pox, and that ointment caused this type of allergy. Actually post chicken pox solar dermatitis, she is working in the university as a clerk, still she is working. And this is kachyadikachyasana deshesu, but the problem is due to deodorant allergy, due to the spray. Different spray is coming. Different spray. That is the allergy due to the spray. And this is actually very interesting. You have to listen. Actually, this is the patient came to me occasionally happening this type of blister formation. And after thorough investigation, she is telling that after application of oil on the head, she is actually the lady is putting oil on. And that oil is the number one oil seeing in the media for hair growth. And after that, I searched all the internet and I came to know with several interrogation with the doctors, and there is a tablet called minoxidil. Have you heard about minoxidil? No, it is used in the Canada. Minoxidil is a tablet used in the Canada for hypertension. And unfortunately or accidentally or fortunately, one doctor noticed that this minoxidil, when applied topically accidentally, the hair growth will increase. But when it is stopped, all the hair will be removing, automatically shedding. This knowledge they used, and this is the tablet adding all the oil in nowadays in the market, which will use for the increasing of the hair. Minoxidil. It is a highly toxic. When it is stopped, when the oil is stopped, again all the hair will be shedding. And for the long term use, it will cause the scalp psoriasis and scalp cancer. That is the effect of minoxidil. Even the one modern MBBS doctor, modern shampoo is there with minoxidil. And almost all the where Kerala students, please note that in Kerala, several oil are marketing in the form of different name for the hair growth. All the oil content is strong. One bottle costs 600 rupees. Minoxidil effect. And now this quadam or blister formation due to, I told you, Jadamayadi. Application of Jadamayadi in the Varshon in the case caused this type of allergy, quadam formation. Now this is atopic dermatitis or Bala Visarpam, Karapan. There is 51 types of Visarpam, and the Bala Visarpam is three types. Atopic dermatitis, infantile stage, adolescent stage, adult stage. And this atopic. This is napkin allergy, Ahipudana, Malovareva, Suedadvya, like that. Ahipudana or Gudaguttam disease is the napkin dermatitis. And now this is condom allergy, usually seeing to people, condom allergy. And this is sanitary pad allergy. This is a very, very chronic case, came from the Gulf. Still, she is cured completely. So these are some of the examples. I have said what are the skin diseases are approaching. Now, management principle. Actually, management principle should be, I told you in the pathological level, in the pathology, the interstitial fluid should be properly maintained, so that when you are doing a virajana or when you are doing some shodhana therapy, you are extracting from some fluid from the body, that will cause some negative pressure in the vascular pool, that it will give the absorption of the accumulated fluid and the tissue from the interstitial fluid, it will absorb, so automatically it will get. Almost all the medicine described in our science contain some virajana, like padola, nimba, like that. So here, Srodha Shodhana and Dosha Shamana for what? To relieve the symptoms, reduce the inflammation, restore the circulation, clear the metabolic channel. And see how you are going to approach in the clinic. This is a case of Vijartika. because all the signs and symptoms are concerned to Pragashi Awa Lesi Gade Vijarthika. And for the management, diagnose first. What is the Nidhanam? What is Samprapti? What is the Lakshanam? Here, Lakshanam Sagandu Pedagashiava Lesi Gade Vijarthika. All the signs and symptoms is clear. You can diagnose the Vijarthika. And Dosha is as much Pitta Kaba Dosha is there. And here, by the Pratyaksha, you can see somewhere Srodha Dushti is also there. So, by the Pratyaksha Pramana, you are understanding that this is the Vijarthika case. And here, Srodha Dushti is there. What is the clinical diagnosis? What is Samprapti? And what is the Nidhanam? By the Darshana Prasna, he is a farmer, he is working in the layman, and by the contact of the mud and some allergic material, so Srodha Dushti is there. Due to the Srodha Dushti, I told you accumulation of the fluid and causing some signs and symptoms. So there are Lakshana and Samprapti and Nidhana. Avoid Nidhana is the first, Nidhana Parivardhanam. At the same time, morphological diagnosis should be there. Rukh Pratikriya is Chikitsa. You have to give Rukh Pratikriya. You have to give comfort to the patient immediately. Otherwise, the patient will go to another doctor. So, give the relief of the itching and some oozing immediately. And Samprapti Vikitana. Do Shodhana Therapy. And avoid the Nidhana. Nidhana Parivardhanam. So, like that, each and every patient you can see. Nidhanam, Samprapti, Lakshanam. And Nidhana Parivardhanam, Pratikriya, Samprapti Vikram. This is the method of management in the dermatological problem. Now, like that, I have given only Guluchiyadi Kashayam with Villayadi Guliya and Tribala Kashaya Charanam with Shadadoda Grida. Within 1 week, the patient got the relief. This is the basic principles of management of dermatological problem. You are clear? The simple thing. And also, advise him to avoid the contact of the mud and other things. Now, think, from my clinical experience, all the dermatological problem we can classify into three types. One is acute test or vada pitta stage, subacute or pitta kavaja stage, chronic or vada kavaja stage. All the patient we can classify into the three stages. Of course, maybe some in the deeper side you have to do some amsha kalpana. But basically, for general practice, you can classify all the disease into the three stages. Now, as per the Charaka, Buddha Jinda, Buddha Bhyo, Hiparam Jinda, Nasti Jinda, Jigilse. From my experience, when you are thinking in the Baudhika level, Buddha level, in the acute stage it is Vata Paitiya, where Vayu and Agni Agasha Buddha will be more. So you have to give Jala Buddha and Prithvi Buddha. The ideal drug, simple drug you can give, Grida is the most important thing. Action and application of Grida you can give. When it is Pitta Kapaja stage, Agni Jala Prithvi will be more. So Vayu Rukshana you have to give. And in that some Kashaya Chalana is very good. In the latter case, I have done only Kashaya Chalana because it was the Pitta Kavaja stage. We have do some Rukshana Kriya by Chalana. And in the Vata Kavaja stage, Vayu and Prithvi will be more. And so we have to give Jalam and Agni. In the Jalam and Agni, it is better to do a Lavana Jala Chalana. Just wash the part with the salt water when it is Vata Kavaja. Within 1 day, the itching will be reduced. This is the simple method of management of dermatology problem with my experience. And now think, this I told you the first case. This is the Vata Pitta stage. Here, Jala Prithvi Bodha Snehana you can give. Here also, here you can give the some Sega with some simple decoction and also application of some Girda, even Mahatikta Girda or Shadadavuta Girda you can apply. And in the Pitta Kavaja stage you can give Kashaya Chalana and some Kashaya Sega. Itching and oozing will be reduced along with internal medicine. And this is Vata Kavaja. Here you can give some Lavana Jala Chalana. The itching and everything will be reduced immediately. So immediate Rukh Pratikriya treatment you can do by thinking in this way. Along with simple medicine, then that I will come. For you think about the medicine, you can use simple medicine, depends upon the quality. Neem is Tikta, that is Agashavayu, more Agnivayu. Here, think about the Bhaudhika level after knowing the Rasa Guna Vidya Vibhaga. And you are thinking in that way. This is Karanjam, these are the some of the drugs, single drug used in the dermatological problem as per the quality of the drug and also thinking in the Bhudigala, that is Karalagam. It is Kashaya Rasa, Tikta Rasa, Kadrasa. Also you can think in the Bhudigala level. And this samanga, this is the durva, and all the medicine you can single. This is parandi, and this is the one most important drug we are using in the Karappan chikitsa. Parandi adikaradailam. Parandi, that is Ixora Koskinia. And this is Kashayarasa, Tikta Kadrasa, Shira Vira Leguna, Pitta Kabashamana. And this parandi is most effective drug in the Balavisarpa chikitsa. Now think, what is happening in the, I told you, drug with this Vada Vidya. Here only I am giving Vilyadi Gula incident Grita Levana, Shadada Uda Grita Levana. And within 2 days, the blister is cured. Within 2 days, thinking in the doshic level, basically. This is same, a heat allergy with this Pitta Kabaja. Here, as per the dosha, so you can think, Guluchari Kashaya Mindanli, Nalpamaradi Kashaya Chalam and Shadada over the Lebanon. You can get this type of result. Within 4 days, you can get the result if you are using in this simple medicine. And this heat allergy, Pitta Kabaja, it is subacute. Give Guluchyadi Kashaya, Kaishwar Gulgulu, Nalpamaradi Chalana and Nalpamara Lebana. You can get this result like this. With immediate result, you can get all the blister and oozing will be cleared, oil allergy. And now, I told you this Balladaka allergy. And here, it is Vada Paitiya. So, Manjishtadi Kashaya with Vilyadi Gulya, Chalana with Vara Churna Kashaya, Lebana with Shadavuda Udagrida. See what is happening after 3 or 4 days. Actually, this patient, is ready to go Gulf for booking his flight. He went to travel agent, and by seeing this travel agent asked what is happening, and he's very much dissatisfied. Without curing this, I am going, I am fed up. And that travel agent fortunately was my patient, and he sent the patient to me, and he came just within 4 days. So I want to go to Gulf, what I can do? And within 3 or 4 days before going, he was like this. And this is another Vata Kabaja again, this solar dermatitis. Here it is Vata Kabaja, it is chronic. Here we have Mahatikta Kashaya or Mahatikta Grida, you can give. If you are giving Grida, it is better to do in a Virajana, because Kosta Ulklesha should work me there. After Virajana, give Mahatikta Grida. Here I am given after Virajana with Avipati Churna, I have given Mahatikta Grida with Aladi Churna application. Now, within 1 week, it will be comfort. And so, even though we can think in the Bhavadika level, single drug you can, but it is not possible to all the practitioners, because nowadays we can see multifactorial etiological causes and multidimensional pathological manifestations in dermatology. So we want a multi-level application of management methodology, targeting, clearing all the srodas, stimulating all the agris, enhancing the organ function, motivating the micro level metabolism. Because